323 is here in the PTU, and we've got some juicy, juicy stuff to test. We've got the clouds, we've got upscaling, entity count changes, render thread performance improvements maybe, water simulation stuff, and of course the big one, Vulkan is in game. Now, this is probably the worst performing patch I've ever played in Star Citizen, even on the PTU. This is a bad one, and you've got to take some of what I'm about to show you with a grain of salt, because when things are on the PTU, there's logging running from CIG's point of view. This is not finished. This will hopefully improve before it goes live, but there are some interesting things that we can see. So let's get in, first of all, with the clouds. CIG have added reference clouds as an option to the cloud settings. Now, I don't know why they've done this. You might not be able to see really much difference here between very high and reference. And as we zoom into 300%, just show you them all, you'll be able to see them getting better and better as they go up. But very high to reference, I think it's very questionable whether there's any real difference. But there is a big difference in the performance. These clouds are even more brutal than they ever were before. So this is tested at 4K with a 7800X3D as a CPU, but the RTX 4080 as the graphics card. Now, at 4K, you really want to keep this stuff on medium, even on a 4080. But the reference clouds are unbelievably brutal. And so even with a 4090, you're not going to be having any decent performance here. I don't really know why CIG have put these in the game. Let's move on. Next up, upscaling. Now, we've got DLSS, FSR, and CIG's TSR as options now in 323, the PTU. In lots of parts of the game, as you all know, this won't help people who are CPU bound, but there are parts of the game where it's quite GPU heavy. So I just did a quick test with DLSS in Quantum Travel here, and you'll see a huge performance of 4K again. Same system as before, 7800X3D with a 4080. At 4K, we're seeing big improvements in frames because we're running at quality, which is effectively 1440p, so it's a lot easier for the GPU. But there is a problem with the upscaling in the game as it currently stands. You'll see here DLSS quality version, and you might notice that some of the UI elements are pretty blurry. And this seems to be the case across all three options. But if I put them side by side, you'll be able to see that for some reason, when you go into nav mode, your UI goes all blurry when you've got one of these different upscaling options on. Not really sure why. I'm sure this sort of stuff will get fixed, but for now, it's probably not quite ready for prime time. Again, it's the PTU, things might get fixed, but the performance in certain scenarios will be there depending on your combination of CPU and GPU, and I will do a proper deep dive into performance of all sorts of different GPUs and combinations at some stage. But for now, there's a quick look at the upscaling options that we've got. I mentioned at the start entity counts. Now, in 322, when you load into Lorville, your entity count is around the 100,000 mark. But on the PTU in 323, in Lorville, I've seen some huge numbers, getting up to around 200,000. So the number of entities that are going on around you that your client, I think, is having to keep hold of seems to be going up and up. Now, it's the same in Orizon. I've been there as well. Entity count way up compared to 322. Who knows exactly why that would be, but we'll have to see whether CIG do anything about that before it actually gets to live. But in better news, the render thread seems to have improved. Now, I wasn't looking for this necessarily. I just noticed that the render thread counter, as I was traveling around, seemed to be really, really low. And when I get to this scene where at the end of my Lorville run, I can look across the New Deal ship shop, you can see in 322 on the left, the render thread is around the 20, 21, 22 mark. But actually it's about half, maybe slightly less than half of that on 323. So it's possible that all the work that CIG have been doing to get Vulkan together has also been combined with improving the Gen 12 renderer, which is what they've been saying for a long time. They'll keep improving it. So potentially the render thread has got better in 323. Let's now have a quick look at the water simulation. First of all, I'm just going to show you how it looks. We're not going to worry too much about performance. This is with no water simulation on. There's still effects that go on, but the water itself doesn't move. But then we go on to very low. You'll see the water effects there, but then they pop out of existence. And again, as you move, you can see them. The water starts to spread out, but then it just pops away. Then we've gone on to, I think, medium. And you can see, again, it's lasting a bit longer. The water is, the wake, basically, from your thrusters is affecting things. And then finally, very high
I think the effect lasts for a greater distance away from you. So if you look right at the end of the trail, I think this looks the best. Maybe there's more effect going on. And I think it looks pretty good. And then I managed to crash.
The difference in performance between them doesn't seem to be massive at this stage, but I will do some proper testing at some stage in the future. The big one, though, is obviously Vulcan. Vulcan is now an option in the graphics menu. You have to restart the client. You can't just change it. You have to actually close down, open up again. But you can see when you've got display info open, you can see what your graphics renderer is. I did my testing, as I love to always do, at Norville here. Now, because the performance is so bad and the trams, the trains or whatever they are in Norville are so all over the place, you often can't complete a run because the train just kind of flies all over the place, floating everywhere. But I did manage on the main system to get 8 runs with DX11 and 8 runs with Vulcan done. And you'll see here my first performance testing of Vulcan. Now, I saw an improvement in performance. Now, I'm not willing to say that that's definitely the case and this is good testing, because as I said, the PTU is all over the place. There's stutters all over the place, interaction delays. It's a complete mess. So I don't think we want to read too much into this, but in the 8 tests that I did on each, it looked as though on this system, at least, Vulcan did perform better. And CIG have come out and said that they haven't got multi-threaded support into this version of Vulcan. So it's still running on one thread, I guess. So this isn't the final version, but in my testing, at least, I guess it's promising that we are going to see a bump on this sort of system with the 7800XGD. I did then try, and I say try, because it is try, I tried to test with the minimum spec system, which has got an i5-10400 in with a 1660 and 16 gigabytes of RAM. Now, this didn't go so well. I'm just going to show you the runs I did. I spent around 2 hours trying to get around Norville and doing some testing here. I just couldn't. It just wouldn't let me complete the runs. There were so many issues with the PTU, and it seemed worse on a lower spec PC. But here are the 4 runs that I managed to complete here, and you'll see, really, the best one is a Vulcan run, but the worst one is also a Vulcan run. So there's no real rhyme or reason here, and there's obviously not enough data to really say anything. But performance is way down compared to the live patch with this system, and it was pretty unusable. But no real conclusions can be drawn about how well Vulcan is working from this. So there's, I guess, a preview of some of the tech coming in 3.23. I'll be doing better and more testing once this gets into live, when it's not got all the logging running on in the background. We'll actually get some real data, but there's hints of what's to come. Let's all hope that CIG don't rush this patch, because currently it really is a mess and performance is significantly down on 3.22 live. But for a performance thing, this is probably the most exciting patch maybe we've ever had. Very exciting things coming, and yeah, lots of testing to do.